The cancer research landscape is at a very pivotal place. For the last 30 to 40 years, we've made huge investments in the science and biology of cancer.
What we're starting to see now are at a cusp of moving to a very personalised approach. So rather than actually working through a series of drugs until you find one that might work for you, we're going to try to find the optimal therapy for you up front.
The traditional model of cancer and the thoughts about cancer was that it was one disease, but it isn't. It's multiple different diseases.
At its core, it's really about what happens at a genetic level to actually make these cells transform into something that we just cannot control.
The really exciting thing we have right now is that genomics, big data, integrated with proper clinical care, we've got the chance of personalising approaches and to point where there may be new approaches to tackling really challenging cancers in the future.
Now what we're seeing is the ability to pinpoint cancers in particular parts of an individual's body or indeed a particular molecular makeup of a tumour.
If we have a large number of patients and we have their genetic blueprint and we have how they've responded to the standard drugs of this time, we can learn from experience. And that larger the cohort, the more insight that we gain.
We're now in a position to take big data, genomics, clinical data, put it all together in such a way that we can use precision medicine in a preventive way.
3 billion base pairs that actually makes up the human genome is now being able to be sequenced. Research informs my clinical practice, and we've got a lab now working at trying to work out what is it about these precancerous lesions that make them become cancerous, and can we actually make differences and prevent people ever getting a cancer. The cancer enigma transcends one discipline, and I think we'll require multiple disciplines to actually crack the problem.
We're seeing these remarkable effects where immunotherapy is now frontline treatment for certain types of cancer. We've set up a collaborative environment where researchers from the various institutes can come together. We can look at analysis of this big data that's generated through these studies, and through analysis of the cancers that those patients have in their immune system, we can work out which molecules of the immune system are involved in recognising and eradicating cancer cells. We may be witnessing the beginning of the end of incurable cancer.
The best treatment decisions for people are made in teams. And increasingly importantly, of course, in that collaboration is the voice of the patient themselves. Nurses are the people who are at the bedside with patients and their families more than any other healthcare provider. And so our ability to really tap into the things that helps people live with the consequences of their disease and their treatment, but critically importantly, come back to that collaborative team and bring messages back into that team.
The personalised approach gives us the best chance to determine upfront what is likely to be the best drug or the best approach. It will also give us insights into the overall risks of that disease and indeed the path the disease is likely to take.
But palliative care research is really at a crossroads, and it's a very exciting time. And palliative care is helping people to live as fully as they can, even in the face of progressive illness. And so the opportunity to map people's genomic profile, not just around their cancers, but also around what treatments might be helpful for them to control symptoms that may be associated with cancer. The findings coming out of our research in palliative care are already having an impact on quality of life of both patients and their families.
As a university, we are really excited at the opportunity to partner with institutions like the WEHI, the Peter Mac, the WECCC. We have developed our own centre and put it along with all the other researchers in the WECCC.
You have an opening into education to bring what we learn from the lab, from the clinics, together to feed off each other, but really importantly to take it straight into our students. Those people who will make sure that the next generation of cancer patients, they will have the best people looking after them and the best minds continuing to look for cures for them.
We're at the cutting edge of two important frontiers. One is what is called personalized medicine, and the other is our commitment to the care and consideration of the whole person. Bringing these two things together, there are not many places in the world where it's happening. We are very fortunate to have the scientific talent. We have the commitment and involvement of our patients, support from the government. But to go further, We need philanthropic support. When people support a cause, they bring to it their resources, but also their passion, their commitment, and their motivation to make a difference. And as scientists and doctors and patients, that's a wonderful thing to have on your side.